today's video. So, it is July 7th. Hey Siri.
Tuesday the 7th of July, 2020.
Yeah. Today's the 7th of July. Why did I say it like that? Today is July 7th, and we are doing a major post-quarantine glow-up. I've been looking like this. Oh god. Most of the time, and sometimes my hair is never like actually out. But you know, I've been trying to work on it. We're gonna do a major glow-up. I have a lot of things planned already. I've been doing my eyelashes. I don't actually do acrylics, but I'm gonna fix up my nails. They're so freaking long. I'm finally getting my hair done. I pray everything works out. Literally, like, Corona is ruining everything. Like, summer is almost over, and what have I done? Absolutely nothing. But we're gonna come out of this looking snazzy, looking cute, looking great. So if this is what you need to go get a haircut, go dye your hair, go do something crazy, you should do it. If you want to go blonde, go blonde. If you want to go brunette, go brunette. Go do whatever you want. Don't let anyone stop you. So I'm finally getting my hair done. I'm so freaking excited. This is how this ugly mess looks. God. I've been obsessed with Sophia Carson's hair. Literally, I'm just obsessed with Sophia Carson, actually. I just want to look like her. So let's see if I can do that. I don't know if this is considered dead hair, but I don't like it anymore. We need to change it up. This is probably gonna take a month because I don't have my hair appointment until the end of the month. So we have a lot of things to do before that. We're not just gonna do a little
cute outfit and makeup.
Look, I'm gonna actually try to do some other things, you know? Okay, so first up on this list is eyelashes. I have been using castor oil to get my eyelashes to be thicker. I kind of have long eyelashes a little bit. I'll insert some pictures and videos of my eyelashes. I've been doing it for 2 days already now, but I'm literally using my old mascara wand, cleaned it out, it's like brand new, and I'm dipping it into my castor oil every night before I go to bed, and I just like put it on my eyelashes like if I was gonna put on mascara, sleep in it, and then in the morning just like wash it up with some lukewarm water. That's what I've been doing. I am gonna post the results, of course, in the video, so I'll tell you how it goes, if it actually works, because I've been wanting to get, like, you know, eyelash extensions or like a lash filler. Is that what it's called? Lash lift? Lash filler? I don't think that's the right word, but I heard like it damages your eyelashes, and I naturally have a lot of like long eyelashes, so I don't really want to ruin that, you know? Okay, so now I'm gonna cut my nails. They need this. I don't have a filer, I couldn't find mine, so that's just gonna be a step out of the wrong direction. But here's how my here's how my nails currently look. Wow, these are so long. Oh my god. Well, at least they're white, you know? They're not like crusty yellow.
She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something that features. You'll find it.
Okay, it's a few minutes later and I cut my nails. I was gonna do those little almonds or squares or whatever the heck I said, but I just cut them really short and now they're like really ugly, so. But they grow back in literally a week, so I'm fine with it. I am about to do my eyelashes and I wanted to talk about like a little skin remedy that I've been doing for like a long time now, and I just wanted to share. So basically at night sometimes, or when I have a pimple usually, so I have a big old one right here, and I have a little one on my cheek right here. That one's kind of bumpy, but I just take ice, I put it in a napkin or a paper towel so it doesn't burn my skin or whatever. Let my skin soak in the cold water. It's like really good for your skin. It opens up your pores. It also gets rid of wrinkles. So if you have any wrinkles, it's really good. I'm gonna do my eyelashes now. So I have my castor oil right here. This part gets a little messy, not gonna lie. Oh, napkins everywhere. And something I've learned from like YouTube videos especially is to go with like try to go as close to the root of your eyelashes as possible, because that will have the most effect for it, so it actually can grow thicker. Okay guys, now it's hair time. So my hair, I feel like it's not damaged, but it doesn't have that shine anymore that I used to have. So I'm gonna be using olive oil now. Like, I used to hate putting oil in my hair. It's like really Indian tradition to, like, you know, put oil in your hair so it's nice, but I hated it, and now I'm being a full-on hypocrite and doing it again. So wow, like, it's not dead or anything, but it just could be better. I feel like I'm gonna try to do this at least once a week before I have to shower, because I'm gonna leave it in for like an hour or so and then wash it out.
We had enough money to park for talking.
I just put the oil in. I'm just putting this towel on. I don't know why, but here's the look. We're just gonna wait for an hour and then I'm gonna go take a shower, and I hope my hair is like Sophia Carson, because that's the goal here. The goal here is to look like Sophia Carson. If you didn't know already, I am obsessed with her and I love her hair so much. Like, I just want to know how she gets her hair like that. So here's the first step in the right direction, I guess. Okay, so it's like a few days, maybe a week later since I last posted the last clip that you just saw. I don't know what that was actually. This video is kind of everywhere, but we're finally at the end of the video. Today's the day where I get my major glow up. So I first want to talk about the castor oil on my lashes. I don't think you can see this at all on camera, but I'll insert pictures. I definitely see like a major difference in my eyelashes. Like, they actually like grew. I'm gonna keep using the castor oil. It literally feels amazing. I'm currently doing my makeup and getting my outfit ready. Actually, my outfit is ready. It's on my desk over there. But I'm getting my hair done today. Like, I'm so excited. I haven't been this excited in so long. That's so lame, but it's been quarantine. I've been stuck at home sometimes. But I'm finally getting that quarantine glow up that I've been wanting. So this is finally going away. I hate this. Do you guys see the three colors? Like the black, the little brown, and then the blonde. Thank God it's going away. God, I hate it. So excited for that. I'm gonna be asking for a honey bronze blonde balayage, if that makes sense. So I still want my natural hair color to show, but I just want, like, I think just a maybe different color. I don't know. The second Kissing Booth movie just came out today, so I'm gonna be watching that while I get my hair done. I heard it's like really good too, so I'm excited for that. Also, next week, literally a week from today actually, on Friday the 31st, it's Eid again, because we have two Eids every year. So I'm gonna have another Eid vlog, which I know you guys like, because those do so well for my channel. But I'm so excited. We're like, me and my friends made some plans.
Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why I'm down, yeah? No friends of mine around, yeah. Now I'm thinking of.
I'm so excited! Okay, I'm gonna shut up now. I'm so excited. I'm gonna go make myself a coffee. You know, we gotta go up and have our caffeine. Duh. I just got my breakfast. I got my iced coffee and my bagels. I love my little bagels. Okay, and for the fete, I'm wearing this top Oh my god, I feel like I look kind of weird. Wearing this top from Shein, like I said, and then these jeans from H&M, and then my jewelry. I have the honey one, and then this little bar one, and then my rings, which I don't know if you can see or not, but they're there, and then the scrunchie, and my necklace, and then I'm gonna be wearing my Converse, I'm pretty sure. Okay guys, I did a little outfit change because I realized that is too fancy, I guess, for a hairdresser. I want to be comfy because I'm going to be sitting there for a long time. So I just did this basic white tee that I cropped and then the jeans and added the belt. I kind of look like a skater girl low-key. Like, I don't know, but you know, I have to be comfy. It's a look. It's a cute little look, I guess. But I'm so comfortable now. I don't know. I feel like oversized t-shirts and all that just make me way more comfortable than like those tight-fitted dresses or tops, which I feel like everyone can agree on. But you know, now we are ready. It is officially 11:34 and I'm heading over in like 30 minutes to the hair salon. So I'm here at the hair salon. I came a little bit too early, so I'm just sitting in my car until like 12:45, which is like in 15 minutes, and then I'm gonna walk in. But I'm here, I'm getting my hair done. Okay, I need to shut up about that. I don't know how many times I've said this in the video already, but here is the before. Honestly, on camera it looks like I'm like, I still have the blonde in there, but it's honestly not like that. Like, I trust, I don't know why it's showing that. I also made a lot of TikToks, so you should go follow my TikTok, because I did like 5 before video transitions of like me getting my hair done. Like, it's a lot. But yeah, also I don't have any gas, so my little indicator button dot thing came on, so you know I'm scared. We're fine. So my camera might be like foggy, but here's the hair. I just got it done. I'm at the hair salon, or I just got out, but my car stopped working. Like, it's not turning on because I ran out of gas, so that's kind of really embarrassing. But like, shut up, this looks so good. Oh my god, I look like a different person. I can't even right now. I have to wait for my dad. So this is like, this blow up is crazy. But like, here's the glow up. Like, how'd I do? Let me know. So yay. I'm gonna be sitting here making my TikToks and waiting for my dad. Guys, I got the gas. My dad finally came. I'll insert the clip. That was really funny. It was the first time for both of us, so you know. Love that. But my hair looks freaking amazing and I freaking love it. You know, we're good to go. You know, that's a story for everyone later on in life. I ran out of gas, the car was jumping up and down. Love it. I'm gonna blast my music now. I'm gonna listen to Taylor Swift and Logic's new album. I'm literally obsessed. Like, this looks so good. And she told me to like go in for another session so I can get the color I really want, but this looks so good. So if you are in Georgia, go to the hair bar at Woodstock, and I had, my stylist was Tori. Oh my god, it's so good. I actually found her through a friend, so this is so good. But let me just get to the point that I've been trying to say for the past 2 minutes. Basically, thanks for watching the video. This is the end of my little quarantine transformation, glow up, whatever you want to call it. I look pretty now. Always tell yourself that. Anyways, I hope you guys liked this video. I had my fit. I'm glad I didn't wear the green one because I was literally sitting in a chair for 3 hours, so it doesn't really matter. And I got some pics. I'll insert them now. That's pretty much it for my glow up. I got my nails done. I try to make my hair like Sophia Carson with some oil. You should do that. It'll make it really nice and healthy. Whatever product she uses, my hair is freaking amazing. My hair is so soft. And the castor oil, which, okay, these are my, this is mascara, so you can't really, you know, tell a difference, but my lashes are so long. Like, it's actually so cool how castor oil works. But yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching this video. Please be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe down below if you're new here. Follow my Instagram, my social media, and I will see you guys in my next video. Peace. That's fact.